It is a sad fact, but more people die from heart attacks during the holidays than any other time of the year. The good news is there is a breakthrough therapy being offered at the University of Chicago Medicine that could repair damage to the heart following a heart attack. I talked to Dr. Sandeep Nathan to find out more.
There's quite a few heart attacks that happen between Christmas and New Year's in the months of December and January. I think it's important to try to differentiate, is it related to the weather or is it related to the holidays? And it seems to be the latter. There's a lot of risk factors that sort of cluster in the holidays, dietary indiscretions, stress related to the holidays, and perhaps delays to actually obtaining medical care. And so I think all of those sort of conspire to increase the risk of heart attacks during the holiday season.
What, for people that have obviously never experienced a heart attack, what goes on in the body when you are experiencing a heart attack?
Well, every organ system requires oxygen, and whenever there's an interruption in the flow of oxygen to an organ system, the tissues start to suffer. That's exactly what happens during a heart attack, where an artery fills up typically with blood clot, cutting off the blood supply to the heart, which mm-hmm. is a muscle, a pump, mm-hmm. And as an unfortunate consequence of that, heart muscle will suffer or irreparably be damaged as a result of it.
And many times we thought that was it. If it was damage done to the heart, there was no way to repair it. But now at the University of Chicago, you guys have a new treatment method that may be able to reverse some of that damage.
We're very fortunate to be among the first in the country to offer a novel therapy known as supersaturated oxygen, or SSO2 for short. Mm-hmm. It's an adjunctive therapy that we provide in addition to the standard of care, which is to open up that blocked blood vessel as soon as we can using angioplasty and stent techniques. These are all catheter-based, minimally invasive techniques that have been used for decades. The problem has been that even though we have gotten technically better at opening up these vessels, the damage and the burden of heart failure that results from these heart attacks has not really changed for a couple of decades. And so what supersaturated oxygen does is basically allows us to get oxygen to the damaged territory independent of the flow of blood, because the oxygen sort of diffuses into the tissues and it helps repair the heart. It certainly helps to mitigate the amount of damage that would have happened otherwise.
And is there a certain period of time that this needs to take place between the time you had the heart attack?
There is a critical time window. So per FDA regulation and approval, patients who are eligible for this therapy need to show up within 6 hours of the onset of their symptoms. They need to undergo a successful angioplasty and stent procedure, which is what we would offer as part of standard of care. And then for 60 minutes after the completion of the procedure, we drip in this very saturated, highly concentrated oxygen directly into the coronary artery that caused the heart attack. And I think one very notable point here is that this is really reserved for big heart attacks that affect the front side of the heart, what's colloquially known sometimes as the widowmaker.
Okay, so who is a candidate for this? Do you have to be a certain age, or is there a certain race or ethnicity that are a better candidate for this procedure?
All patients that are presenting with an anterior heart attack affecting the front side of the heart, typically affecting the left anterior descending coronary artery, or LAD for short, and as I mentioned, often this is referred to as the widowmaker for unfortunately appropriate reasons, are eligible for this. And so it does apply to a very large population of patients. Keep in mind that in the United States, somebody's having a heart attack every 40 seconds. That maps out to almost 800,000 heart attacks per year, and a significant chunk of those could potentially benefit from this therapy.
So typically after a person suffers that widowmaker heart attack, they don't go on to have very good outcomes either as well.
You know, it's highly variable. The unfortunate reality is that 1 in 5 patients who have an ST elevation MI, which is the type of heart attack that we're talking about, even with successful catheter-based therapies, can then go on to have heart failure. And unfortunately, congestive heart failure is a lifelong condition for many of these patients. What this therapy aims to do is to mitigate some of that damage and save a significant chunk of these patients, perhaps somewhere between 25 to 40% of these patients from from going on to have heart failure.
So it's important to get this done as soon as possible.
It is. There's a critical time sensitivity to this therapy, and I think that as we move forward, more institutions, all institutions that are taking care of patients with heart attacks should consider offering this.
All right. You can reach the University of Chicago Medicine Heart and Vascular Center by calling the number that you see there on your screen. For more information on SSO2 therapy, you can visit the website there also on your screen.